Hello friends, in this video we are going to talk about the Evergrande crisis. What impact will it have on the globe, on India, how you should be positioning your portfolio, whether you should be worried or not worried. We try to decode everything about this and discuss. I am Varun Agarwal and let's get started. So if you are new to the channel, please do subscribe and hit the bell icon and you can join our free Telegram channel as well. So what is Evergrande? Evergrande is a real estate company of China. I'll try to make this discussion as simple as possible. It's the second largest real estate company in China. It is one of the global Fortune 500 companies. So now you can imagine the size of the company, and it is one of the biggest in the world in terms of the amount of revenue it gets. It is listed on the Hong Kong Stock Exchange and it employs directly more than 2 lakh people, and indirectly it has generated about 3.8 million jobs in China. It is founded by a man called Zhu Xiaying, who was China's richest man, and now his wealth has become half. This company owns more than 1300 projects in China in more than 280 cities, and yearly they generate revenue more than 80,000 crores. So this company, other than the real estate business, over a period of time they have diversified into other businesses like electric vehicles, sports theme parks, and in the segment of food and beverages, where they started selling bottled mineral water. In 2010, they even bought a soccer team, and they also planned, or they in fact are building the biggest soccer stadium in the world. Even after the crash, the market cap of the company is more than $31.2 billion. So you can imagine what is the size of this company. Let's discuss some facts and figures about the company and this crisis. As we have discussed, the present market cap is around $31 billion. It has more than $300 billion USD as debt. So this is the biggest concern why everybody across the globe are worried. Because this liability for this company is asset for several others. So if this company becomes bankrupt, all the people or all the companies to whom Evergrande owes this $300 billion will lose that money. This amount is equal to 2% of entire China country's GDP, and Evergrande holds about 4% of the Chinese real estate high yield dollar bond market. So if the company fails, it is also going to affect the bonds market in China. The share price of this company has fallen more than 85% due to this news, but we'll see the chart in the coming slides where I'll try to discuss with you an interesting thing. The company led into non-core businesses, like they built a soccer school, then spent about $185 million in it, and they constructed a soccer stadium for $1.5 billion USD. As of now, this company has exposure to about 128 banks and 121 non-banking financial institutions. So all these people, whether with a smaller amount or a bigger amount, will get impacted if this company becomes bankrupt. What has happened? What exactly is this incident? What is this crisis? So Evergrande, over a period of time, they borrowed irrationally in excess of their paying capacity, and they went on constructing a lot of projects in China. So there was an interesting regulation imposed by the Chinese government to keep a control on the companies which are raising debt. So there were different grades which were given to the companies, like green, yellow, orange and red. If somebody enters into the red grade, the government would not allow that company to borrow more funds. So there were certain parameters which the government highlighted, and if there are violations in those limits, then the color code will become darker. So the liability to asset ratio should be about 70%, net debt to equity ratio should be 100%, which is 1, and cash to short term debt multiple of more than 1. If there is no violation, you can grow the debt year on year at the rate of 15%. If there is one violation, you can grow only at 10%. If there are two violations, you can grow only at 5%, and if you are violating all the three conditions, then you can't borrow more debt, and your color code will keep on increasing from green to red. So Evergrande is already in the red zone now, and due to this liquidity crunch, Evergrande is now unable to pay their interest payments and EMI installments. What has caused this problem, and why is Evergrande facing this crisis? Because of the excessive borrowing, and the borrowing was done for unrelated diversification into businesses which were not their core businesses. They went into the EV segment, manufacturing of electric vehicles. They went into the sports theme. They went into grocery and dairy business. And they also went into the theme parks. And some of these businesses which they have started are making negative cash flows, are in losses. And the main business is trying to fund these businesses, and somehow they are trying to run these businesses. And in fact, they have even started selling some of these businesses, and they are open to sell the other businesses to consolidate and go back to their earlier track record. Just to give you an example, in 2014, when they launched the mineral water brand, they paid about 6 billion yuan in advertising, and one of the advertisers was Mr. Jackie Chan. So this is the scale of expenditure the company is incurring in the unrelated businesses. So the primary reason for the incidents was excessive debt and diversification to unrelated businesses. Now, what is going to happen if Evergrande defaults and if it becomes bankrupt? There will be a huge impact on the financial institutions who have lent money to the company. They will have to write off that in their books, other than whatever minimal amounts they are able to recover by the dissolution of their company. It will also impact the Chinese real estate sector and the global real estate sector to a certain extent. It will drastically impact the global commodity prices, as China is one of the biggest producers and consumers of steel in the world. As the real estate sector in China will go into a downturn, it will impact, in fact, it has already started impacting the commodity prices, and this will globally affect the other countries also. As you've seen, there are lakhs of people working with the company. All those people will get affected, they will lose their jobs, and all those who have bought their houses in the projects which Evergrande has taken up will not get the delivery of their houses, and there is a chance that they lose their money also. In different ways, this crisis will affect, and once this effect begins, it will become like a ripple effect, and it will start spreading to other sectors and other industries in China, as well as to a certain extent to the other countries of the world which are closely working with China in terms of their import or export business. Now, what could be the global impact? Globally, people are comparing this with the Lehman crisis, but this is a bit different from that. Lehman crisis, the scale of money involved was much higher, and due to the Lehman crisis, the world is more prepared to handle such situations and to revive such companies to protect the Chinese economy and the economies of the world. And China being a controlled country, the impact will not be spread across the globe, as US was a more global economy. Other impacts like the commodity prices, the unemployment factor, all these will also have an impact across the different countries of the world. What could be the impact on the Indian market or the Indian economy? The positive, there are certain positive as well as the negative things. The positive things are that the institutional investors who are invested in China, they may become skeptical and they may think of moving their investments from China to other developing countries. And one of that country for their best choice would be India. So this will help increase the liquidity in the Indian stock market. With these kind of situations, the Chinese government will become more careful and they will increase the amount of regulations in China, where doing business with China will become a little more difficult for the different companies across the globe, and they will focus on looking at other alternatives like the Indian country. At present, China's image is already having a dark spot because of the COVID crisis. Now, Evergrande crisis is adding another issue to their image. Now, what could be the negative on the Indian economy? It will drastically impact the commodity prices. Although the Indian companies are doing well, they are not just doing because of the commodity prices. There is inherent demand of the commodities in India, but still there will have an impact of the reduction in the commodity prices. In fact, there's a small impact which you have already seen in the recent correction in the commodity sector companies' share prices seen in India. Another effect would be that the Chinese currency may become undervalued. So due to this, there may be more imports from China, because the other companies would get goods cheaper when the Chinese currency becomes undervalued. So this will create, in fact, competition for the Indian economy in terms of products like textiles, chemicals, and the other products. So on a broad basis, how the situation can turn up, let's discuss. There are two things which can happen. Either the government will intervene or the government will not intervene. If the government intervenes, then they will save the company. In fact, the People's Bank of China has already started infusing money in the economy to create more liquidity. If the government does not intervene, there could be two situations again. Evergrande will try to save itself on its own, and it would be successful. And the second situation where it will not be successful. If it is not able to save itself, then all the situations which we have discussed earlier will arise. The world has to face those repercussions. If Evergrande saves itself, then it's well and good for the country, the company, and for the world. What is the update from Evergrande's management? They are pretty confident that they will walk out of this issue, and they will repay all the loans gradually over a period of time. They will in fact deliver all the projects they have taken up. But these are only overall statements. There is no fixed tangible plan which the company's management has discussed till now. Now, if you see the chart of this company, there is an interesting thing which I wanted to convey. The last 3 years, the price has been falling. It's not just a sudden fall in the next in the last 2-3 days because of this news. So if at all somebody is invested in such companies, we are just discussing this as a case study for our learning for our future investments. If something goes wrong in a company and you see the on the chart, and if you're able to see on the chart for years together, and you would obviously know the reasons for that by reading the news that the company is taking high debt or they are unable to pay their loans, then you shouldn't be waiting till the last moment for the complete crash to happen. If you are a wise investor, you would have picked up the signal earlier in 2018-19 and you must have made an exit then and there. So this is something which I wanted to convey with the help of a chart, that it is not a sudden crash, something which happens when some fraud in a company is announced. So this is a gradual downfall, although there is a sudden jerk at the end, but still it's a gradual downfall which has happened over a period of 2-3 years. What are the learnings for us from this crisis and such incidents? We should stay away from companies which have excessively high debt. We should also stay away from companies which are entering into businesses which are not their core businesses and where they are not having expertise or they don't have an efficient team to manage those businesses. If at all a company which you are planning to invest in is having past loan defaults, you should get very critical. You should be regularly tracking whatever the company's developments are if you are invested in those companies, and don't be under an impression that the biggest of the large caps will not fail. There have been instances in the past, and now there is one more instance that the biggest companies of the world can also fail and become bankrupt. So whatever are our learnings from this incident, you should keep those in mind and keep a check on all the companies which are there on your portfolios. So this is about Evergrande crisis. I hope you liked the discussion and you had some interesting learning and insights from this case study. If you like the video, please hit the like button and subscribe and hit the bell icon. If you want me to make more videos on such topics, you can leave the names of the topics in the comments below. I would take up and make such case studies for the benefit of our friends on the channel. Thank you for watching this video and have a wonderful day.